Welcome you all. So, in that previous series, we were discussing about the bacterial gene transfer. There were several methods like transformation, conjugation, and now we are going to discuss about the transduction. Okay. So, in the previous two methods, you have seen several procedures how genes are transformed, like heat or some solution or some mechanism, cell division mechanism. So now transduction means when some genes are actually transferred in the bacteria through a virus vector. Okay, so when this is the important thing of transduction, that when you have heard the term like animal virus, plant virus. Okay, so when virus is associated with a bacteria, then it is called bacteriophage or phage virus. Okay, so phage virus is a viral molecule or viral organism, unicellular organism, which actually carries the gene and transfer into the bacterial cell. Okay, so in the history, you can see Zinder and Lindenberg in the year 1952, they have first identified, means they have discovered the whole thing in the Salmonella species. Okay, so this is important for MCQ. When the conjugation process were taking place, they observed that some bacteria are actually infected with some viral vector. Okay, so then they identified the viral and named the bacteriophage. The phases of transformation, before, as I was discussing in the last class, if we want to discuss about the transduction, we need to discuss about the, we need to understand about the lytic and lysogenic cycle. So lytic cycle, you know that lytic and lysogenic cycle, already you have studied in your previous syllabus or in this syllabus by different teachers. Lytic cycle is nothing but it's just attachment and inserted. They penetrate the whole bacteriophage inside the cell, bacterial cell, and they just fragment it. They just cut the bacterial genome along with the viral genome. They also cut, and they will then recombine means they will just then package inside the virus, bacteriophage virus, and then the bacterial cell will die by cell burst. The cell membrane will be burst and all the phage will be released. Okay, so this is the lytic cycle. In case of lysogenic cycle, what happened is completely different. Lysogenic cycle means, so bacteria when attached to a virus, so virus just penetrate the genetic material inside the bacterial cell, and bacterial genome and viral genome will be recombined, will be integrated. Okay, so integrated or recombined, there will be no question of cut. Integrated and recombined, then integrated and recombined inside the cell will be intact, means the bacterial cell will be, the host cell will be intact. Then cell division will be taking place. This is the important thing. In case of lytic, there is no question of cell division because the whole bacteriophage inserted into the bacterial cell, and then cell membrane, bacterial cell membrane will be burst, all the phages will be released. But in case of lysogenic, cell division, the recombined integrated genome along with the cell will be undergo cell division. And cell division means from one cell to two cells will be there carrying the two different and recombined genome. So these two cells, bacterial cells, one will go for lysogenic and another one will go for lytic. In this picture, you can see here, suppose in case of lytic cycle, and this is the lysogenic cycle. This is the phage virus, is virus-mediated gene transfer. It's nothing but overall, this is the transduction. And you can see here, in case of lytic cycle, what happened when phage attached to the cell and inject the DNA here. Okay, so the DNA injected. Here you can see the DNA molecule is injected, or RNA molecule in some cases is injected. Then phage DNA circular is an enters into the lytic cycle or lysogenic cycle. If it is goes like this, this is the lysogenic cycle, and if it is enters this side is the lytic cycle. Lytic cycle means I told you these two genome will be cut and randomly packaging will be there. Packaging means this is the first virus cell, and the packaging means in this head you can see the packaged DNA. Okay, packaged DNA, then the bacterial cell membrane will be burst, all the bacteriophage will be released here, okay, along with the genetic material. So here in this case you can see the bacterial cell, it is dying. But in case of lysogenic, you can see once there is no question of cut all the two different genetic material. They just entered and they integrated and make a bigger volume of genetic material. See here in the red color is the viral genome and this is the bacterial genome. And they integrated and they just undergo the cell division and produces two cells. Okay, in this picture it is not shown, two cells they are producing. And once they produces two cells, one will again go lysogenic and another will go for lytic cycle. Okay, here one thing I want to clear, this lytic cycle transaction is called generalized transaction and this is called specialized transaction in case of lysogenic cycle. Okay, so lysogenic cycle is the specialized transaction and lytic cycle is the generalized transaction. You can see in the video in case of lysogenic, see this is the DNA molecule of the viral vector is inserted here and then it is integrated along with the bacterial host cell and they make the multiple copies followed by the cell division, make two different cells. Okay, so one cell here in this picture you can see one cell will go in the lytic cycle again and another cell will go in the lysogenic cycle. Okay, so in the same picture you can see the cell division is occurred, this is the attachment, then it will be released the genetic material, then recombine, the red portion is the incorporation of the genetic material or integration, then replication means the making of two copies followed by the cell division, and then it will go again one lytic cycle and another one lysogenic cycle. Okay, so what happened in case of lytic cycle, you can see clearly again. See, this is the attachment phase, chromosome is inserted here, and then break down the bacterial chromosome by phase specific enzyme. The phase specific enzyme will act and bacterial chromosome will be cut, and then phase chromosome replication of the bacterial chromosome will be there, and then packaging means phase heads being assembled, phase viral phase head will be assembled and all the genetic material will be randomly inserted into the heads. Randomly means the bacterial chromosome may be inserted, DNA may be inserted, or itself the phage DNA may be inserted. So you cannot regulate them initially. So all the things randomly can be inserted in the bacterial phage heads. Okay, then this packaging is completed, is called the assembly or progeny phase particle. And then this bacterial cell will be burst and all the phage will be released. This is the lytic cycle, is called the generalized transduction. And in case of lysogenic, this is called the specialized transduction. So thank you for watching. I hope you understand this thing. Thank you.